September 2nd, a man, age 18, was arrested for committing lewd acts on a child and possessing child pornography on September 4th. A cell phone was stolen and reported. September 5th, several propane tanks were stolen from Smashburger. September 5th, a man, age 34, was arrested for prowling and trespassing. A 23-year-old man was arrested on an outstanding warrant that same day. A man, age 42, was arrested on a misdemeanor warrant that same day. The rear window of a car, parked car, was broken, causing $250 in damage. September 6th. Car keys were stolen from a home to steal property from a car between September 6th and 7th. A woman, age 22, was cited for stealing merchandise from Target. Property was stolen from a car on September 7th. A man, age 48, was cited on an outstanding warrant. A 56-year-old man was arrested on an outstanding warrant that same day. Another man, age 27, was arrested on an outstanding warrant. There's three in one day. Outstanding warrants. That same day, property was stolen from locked motorhomes, cars, and boats at the storage unit in town. Mail was stolen at homes. September 8th, a man, age 44, was arrested on two outstanding warrants. A car, excuse me, a car was stolen later that day, September 9th. Several walls were vandalized with graffiti between September 9th and 10th. A man, age 24, was arrested on an outstanding warrant and for possessing methamphetamine and a glass pipe. A 33-year-old man was arrested on outstanding warrants. A driver's side window of a car was smashed to pieces, but nothing was stolen. An elderly woman was robbed at her home. Between September 5th and September 11th, police arrested one person for driving without a license or on a suspended license. Between September 4th and 5th, one person was arrested for driving under the controlled substance, and 19 people were arrested on various drug charges. 11 people were arrested for public intoxication. Well, now what? That's my favorite part of the morning newspaper. Actually, it's the next day's morning newspaper. I get it on Friday. And I end up reading it on Saturday. I heard some stuff about the debate. The debate the other day at Reagan Library. The Reagan Library is pretty cool. I've been there a lot. Air Force One and everything. Quilt show. I've never been interested in quilts, but all the people are, they're always having quilt shows. Be wary of knock-knock burglars. Home invasion. Robbery prompts concern. After a local home invasion robbery by three men posing as construction workers. As construction workers earlier this month. I didn't hear about that. Sheriff's officials are warning residents to be cautious when a stranger knocks on the door. The burglary took place on the morning of September 9th when a man knocked on the door of a home and claimed he was a construction contractor. While he was talking with the 84-year-old homeowner in the front yard, two other men entered the home and started searching for valuables. The woman's 60-year-old daughter surprised the thieves inside the home. As they ran out, they pushed the daughter in to the floor. She was not hurt. After the robbery, investigators received calls that led them to believe the robbers may have been knocking on other doors in the area. We have had other house invasion robberies from crews. Coming in from outside of the county. But we're not sure if they were from outside the county or inside the county. What we'd like to do is make the public aware of anyone suspicious coming to their door. Distraction is a common way thieves enter a residence when someone is home. It's easy for someone to be distracted, especially if it's every magician's trick. Look at this hand and don't look at any other hand. If a stranger shows up and residents have any doubt on their mind, call the police. President should try to take, residents should try to take note of what the suspicious person looks like so they can get a good description. If they get a license plate number, that may be very helpful. Police said the burglars jumped into a white Dodge 1500 quad cab pickup and sped away. Anyone with information, call. Oh, that's spooky. That's terrible. I only like reading the spooky stuff in the paper. I noticed that about myself. Well, I hope you guys have a good rest of your day today. It's Saturday. It's a nice start of my day, calm and quiet, relaxing with paper. Thanks for watching.